6 a.m. Christmas morning. No shadows, no reflections here. Lying cheek to cheek in your cold embrace.
Those two little white marks on the throat that I wrote you about.
And which perhaps brought me here so quickly.
What were they like? Just two little white dots with red centers. She must have run a safety pin through the skin of the throat, trying in delirium to fasten a scarf or shawl.
Perhaps. And your daughter's symptoms are the same.
Precisely. She too speaks of bad dreams. Van Helsing, you live in the tropics. May this not be something alien to her medical experience in England?
It may indeed, my friend.
You're loud of
your
witness, man!
What am I facing?
You hear us talking?
Words!
Don't come here, Philip. You know you mustn't wander about this way. How did you get out of your room?
Wouldn't you like to know?
How are the flies? Mr. Renfield here makes a hobby of eating flies. I believe he eats spiders too sometimes, don't you, Renfield?
Will you walk into my parlor? Said the spider to the fly. Excuse me, Doctor. Not introduce me to your friend.
Oh, that's enough now. Come right here.
Humor him.
Tell the attendant to come at once.
Yes, sir.
Very well, Professor Van Helsing, Mr. Renfield, a patient of mine.
Ah! Who does not know of Van Helsing? Your work, sir, in investigating certain obscure diseases, not altogether unconnected with forces and powers that the ignorant who do not believe exist, has won you a position that prosperity will recognize.
You love me, don't you?
Yes, sir, with all my soul.
Just as soon as you're well enough, I'm going to take you away. We'll be married next month. We won't wait. We'll stretch that honeymoon month to 3 months, and the house will be ready in July.
Oh, John, you think we could?
Of course, why not? My mother wanted us to wait, but she'll understand. And I want to get you away. Why do you shrink when I kiss you? You're so cold, Lucy. Always so cold.
Forgive me, dear. I'm yours. All yours. Oh, Sean, I'm so tired. So tired.
Lucy, dear, this is my old friend, Professor Van Helsing.
Ah, my dear Miss Seward. You don't remember poor old Van Helsing. I knew you when you were a little girl. About so high. And now, what charm. What beauty. A little pale, yes? Will you bring the roses back to the cheeks?
You are so kind to come, Professor.
And this, no doubt, is the fortunate young man you are to marry.
Yes, John Harker, Professor.
Look here, Professor, I'm not going to get you away, but if Dr. Seward will have me, I'm going to make him give me a bed here until Lucy gets over to sleep.
Oh, but you do come. I look forward to your visits. You seem to make me better.
And so I arrive to find a rival in the field.
You encourage me, Miss Seward, to make them more frequent as I should like to.
I am always glad to see you.
Ah, but you have been lonely here.
And my efforts to amuse you with our old tales will no longer have the same success. Now that the professor is here with you, and the fact that Mr. Harker is to remain here.
How did you know I was going to stay, Count?
I remember hearing dogs barking before I went to sleep. The air seemed depressing. I left the reading lamp up by my bed, but when the dream came, there seemed to come a mist in the room.
Was the window open?
Yes, I always sleep with my window open.
No, of course. You're English. We Continentals are not so particular about the fresh air. And then?
The mist seemed so thick I could just see the lamp by my bed. A tiny spark in the fog, and then I saw two red eyes staring at me and a livid white face looking down at me out of the mist. It was horrible!
There, there. Go on.
Lucy, dear, you have nothing to fear.
I want you to lie down here, my dear.
But, Doctor...
You trust me, do you not? I want you to lie down here for just a little.
But I'm so frightened.
Make your mind passive. Try not to think. Sleep, if you can.
I dare not sleep. It is when I sleep that he comes to me.
I know, my dear. I know. I'm going to cure you with God's help.
Oh, but, Father...
You must do as the professor says. Come, Harker.
Come, Harker.
Better, I hope. Oh, where that dog went, you can't find him anywhere. Hiding from me.
Who is that?
Excuse me, Ben. Let me see the governor, Matt Looney. He is out again, he is.
And what would he be doing here? You'll not hold your job, you won't, if you can't keep that man safe and sound. Why, he gets out every night.
Don't go, miss.
Miss Lucy's asked for the evening paper.
Forgive me. My footfall's not heavy. And your rugs are soft.
It's all right, sir, but how did you come in?
The door to this room was ajar, so I did not bother knocking. But tell me, how's Miss Lucy in a nervous prostration?
I think she's better, sir.
Ah, good. But the strain of Miss Lucy's illness has made you also ill.
How do you know, sir? But it's only a pain in my head that runs down to the neck.
I can remove this pain.
I don't understand, sir.
Such pain is your remedy. It's a suggestion.
Excuse me, sir, but if it's hypnotism, you mean I think I'd rather have the pain.
You think of hypnotism as an ugly waving of arms in many passes. That is not my method. What is given can be taken away.
What is given?
From now on, you have no pain. And no will of your own.
No longer have any pain.
Do you hear me?
I have no
pain. I hear you.
Do you hear me?
You wake, you will not remember what I say.
I'll remember what I say.
Dr. Seward has ordered you today to sleep with your mistress every night because of her bad dreams. Is it not so?
Yes, master.
Your mistress is threatened by horror and by death, but I will save her. The man whose words that cross purposes of mine has come to this house.
I will crush you.
I will crush you.
Receive your orders. Do you hear me?
Yes, master.
Hear and obey.
From now on, you'll carry out any suggestion that reaches you instantly from my brain without question. When I will need to do a thing, it shall be done. My call will reach you soon.
It was built, as you said, Harker, by the terrible void named Dracula, who was said to have dealings with evil spirits. The last of his race. But for many generations, the peasants have believed the castle Dracula, inhabited by a vampire.
Then it must be he.
My friends, I'd be willing.
But surely this confirms your suspicions. I was incredulous till I saw the creature hovering over Lucy.
The vampire from Transylvania cannot be in England.
But why?
Because as I have told you, a vampire must rest by day in the earth tomb in which it was buried.
In the earth.
A vampire must return to its burial place before sunrise.
I found today that Dracula arrived at the Croydon Aerodrome in a 300 German plane on March 6th.
March the 6th?
3 days before Mina was first taken ill. Yes, the plane had made a non-stop flight from Seckley in Transylvania.
It left just after sunset and it arrived 2 hours before dawn. It carried only the count and 6 packing cases.
Did you learn what was in those cases?
He told the customs people he wanted to see whether Transylvania plants would grow in a foreign climate in their native soil.
Soil? What was in those boxes?
Just plain dirt. He left the lorry with 6 coffin-like boxes before sunrise.
Oh god, yes! Before sunrise! The king of vampires, my friends! This creature is a terrible boy of an age Dracula himself! But who can suspect? 500 years he has been fed into his castle, because he must sleep by day in his graveyard. 5 centuries pass, the aeroplane is invented. His chance has come, for now he can cross Europe in a single night. Prepare 6 cases filled with the earth in which he must rest by day. He leaves his castle just after sunset. By dawn he is in London and safe in one of his cases. A great risk, but he has triumphed. He's reached the great London, with its teeming millions. With its opportunity, as he said.
Oh God, protect my Lucy! I saw the estate agent from whom he bought Carfax. He got the addresses of 4 old houses he has leased in different parts of London.
One of his coffin receipts is in each of those houses.
2 boxes were delivered at Carfax the day after you took possession.
He has scattered them, for safety. If we can find all 6, we can destroy him.
But how?
His native earth will no longer receive his unclean form, and each box is sanctified with holy water.
Then we must get at those boxes. Tear them open one by one. If we find him, then in God's name, Professor, I demand that my hand shall grab the stake into this devil's heart and send his soul to hell.
He's been here all the time he's been talking.
Did you hear what we were saying, man?
Yes, I heard something. Enough. Be guided by what he says. It is your only hope. It is her only hope. It is my only hope! Save my soul! Save my soul! I am weak. You are strong. I am crazy! You are sane! You are good and he is evil!
I will save you, Renfield, but you must tell me what you know. Everything!
No? What should I know? I don't know anything! You say I'm mad and Dr. Seward will tell you about that! You mustn't pay any attention to anything I say!
We can't waste time with this fellow! I'll have him taken away!
Fool! Fool! I thought you were wise. The whole world is mad. Just now. And if you want help, you must come to a madman to get it. I will not help you, I'm afraid. Wise madmen will obey him who is strong, and not the weak.
Him? Whom do you mean?
Need we mention names among friends? Come, Professor, be reasonable. What have I got to gain by being on your side? The doctor keeps me shut up all day. If I'm good, he gives me a little sugar to spread out for my flies. But on the other hand, if I serve him...
The blood of the light, eh, Renfield? What do you have to do with Count Dracula?
Dracula? I never even heard of that name before.
You're lying!
Madmen, Professor, lack the power to discriminate between truth and falsehood. So I take no offense to what most men would consider an affront. Send me away. I asked you before you wouldn't. You only knew what has happened since then. I dare not tell you more! I dare not! I should die in torment if I betray him!
But the Seward will send you away if you speak.
Yes, Renfield. I offer you your soul in exchange for what you know.
God? Who am I, damn a poor lunatic's soul? God knows devils too strong for us all weak minds! But send me away. I want you to promise, Dr. Seward!
If you will speak.
Come, Renfield.
I will tell you. Count Dracula is